There's a couple of things. If some of you guys are starting like here with this like really deep foot, even almost under the body, I'm not trying to armbar you here. I got really good triangle finish here. This is where we go back to day one, which was clear, hide, base, okay? We're gonna assume that it's already bad, all right? Where the foot is not under the back, the foot is not where the shoulder is, it's more under the head, okay? This is, we have to start with this basic positioning or it's gonna be really hard. It's super hard when you guys have the knee buried in really deep here and then now you're trying to come over the top to bring your knees together because I'm falling forward now, okay? This is what I want to avoid. We're sitting back because we had to sit back. We had a bad jump, all right? Now I'm sitting more with my weight towards my butt and I have free access to use my hands on the arm. If I'm out here, I don't have access to start using my arms for the arm bar. I can maybe posture up and start to do one of these things, right? But that's kind of that high risk, low reward kind of stuff. That's where you get bridged over, okay? And then you try to finish on the roll. And we talked about that a little bit. From here, I'm thinking control first. Pin, pressure. Pin and pressure, and then I'm working my submission. And I can just keep going at it all day. If you guys don't get it first try, it doesn't matter. Just keep pressuring and keep pinning, and then you're working on the arm bar and the wrist lock separate, right? And if I'm doing all three of those things at the same time, if I'm constantly applying pressure, eventually I'll get something, right? If not, I'll make his life so miserable that if he does get out, he's not gonna wanna fight anymore. He'll be tired, all right? So one of the things I think with the wrist lock is some of you guys were trying to finish out here where you're coming after the wrist and you're bringing your heads forward, okay? I wanna smash, but I'm not doing this to put my weight forward, okay? I push the elbow here and I just kinda put my body weight down on the arm. So I'm more like hunching, like just trying to smash straight down so that I'm trapping the elbow. Once the elbow's trapped, now I can do whatever I want with this wrist and I wanna go make sure that I'm pulling so the palm down, not this way. You can try to finish this way, it's just harder, right? If I can get access to this opening here, if this is extending, this is much easier to get the tap. All right, this is a lot harder to get the tap this way. So here, when I go for the arm bar, a lot of you guys are posting out here. See how far away my hand is, right? I don't want to be finishing out here where I'm leaning forward, okay? This is okay, but it's not ideal, all right? If I go back towards here, it's easy for me to pull this arm away from where your defense is. And it's super hard for you to bridge. Now, you can't bridge out of here because I'm putting all my weight on your chest. Here, it's easier for you to sneak out the back door. You can start really strong guys can start pushing into you. And I'm gonna have a hard time holding this and keeping my base, okay? Here, if he tries to bridge, it's a lot easier for me because I can just sit my butt back, okay? And I can start to extend the arm. When I get the arm extended here, I'm taking my weight, again, towards the chest. I'm not taking my weight and putting it on my hand. My weight is always going towards my butt cheek, here. Now, some of you guys are bringing your foot and putting your foot on the ground, right? I don't want my foot on the ground. I don't want my foot holding any weight. I just want to bring my knee to knee, okay? I don't have to use my foot to put any weight on. Now, I extend, tap. When I fall off to the side, some of you guys are just bailing on the arm. You're getting lazy on the arm. You're getting lazy on the body. When I fall back, I'm tight. I'm keeping the arm glued to my chest, and I'm bringing everything with me, okay? I'm keeping my legs tight. I'm keeping my knees together, I'm keeping my heels together, and I'm keeping the arm tight to my chest, taking it with me. Now from here, she can't escape. The only way out is to try and pull this arm out the back, and I'm nice and tight, so that's not gonna happen. If he tries to get his head out or his arm out, there's nowhere to go, and he can't go that way. Whereas if I fall off and I let him go over here, he's gonna start to like hitchhiker and stuff, and then I'm gonna have all kinds of problems, okay? So make sure that when you're falling back, you're trying to finish the arm bar kind of that whole way back, and I'm trying to pull him with me. I'm taking his head with me, with my feet, and I'm taking the body with me with my arm, okay? Let's do one more time. We'll do no jump, just start from the bad triangle, finish wrist lock, arm bar, reset, wrist lock, arm bar, two times, switch top to bottom. One, two, three.